Hello everyone, it's Milk, and today I'm going to show you how to get to JB by Tuas, the second link to pump your petrol. So of course I'll bring you to the nearest petrol station. For the benefits of those who have never been to JB via second link before, I'm going to tell you roughly what's the procedure like. So it's basically like the one in Woodlands, just that this one you have to pay the toll fee. So you are gonna need to have your cash card with you. You're also going to need Touch and Go, which is the cash card for Malaysia. So what's gonna happen is, once you reach the Singapore custom, there will be a machine. So two machines, one for your pillion and one for you. So first you insert your own passport. After that, it will ask you to insert your pillion passport. After that, the barricade will open. Then you can go through the barricade. Then that's where you need to scan your thumbprint and also insert your Singapore cash card. After that, the barricade will open. Then it means you are cleared from the Singapore custom already. Then you can go straight all the way to Malaysia custom. But when you're at the Singapore custom, when you're scanning your thumbprint, remember you have to remove your helmet as well. After that, you will proceed straight all the way to the Malaysia custom. And at the Malaysia custom, it's pretty easy. You don't have to remove your helmet or anything. You just give them your passport. Then you can go ahead once you're cleared. Then after going for about 2 or 3 minutes more straight, you will see the toll gate. That's where you need to take out your Touch and Go and need to scan it. Then the barricade will open, then you can go through it. So let's say if you don't have a Touch and Go, don't worry. That's what I did the first time when I went to Malaysia by this way. I didn't have my Touch and Go, so I just purchased one at the toll gate area. If you need to purchase one, you need to go to the first gate, which is the one that's the furthest. I'll show you where is it later. Anyway, because I don't think they allow filming in the custom, I already have my camera on, but I'm going to cut the video off before I reach the custom. Before you enter, make sure you have enough petrol. The distance from the checkpoint to the petrol station is about, I think, around 20 km. So actually it's pretty far, because you need to make a big U-turn before you can reach the petrol station. Because the first exit you can take to make a U-turn is actually pretty far. It might sound a bit unclear to you now, but I'll show you later and it will all be very easy. And if you are going to JB through second link, don't worry about the jam. Weekdays after about 9 p.m. is almost empty. When I say almost empty, I mean you don't even have to queue at all. And for weekends, I'm not that sure also, because I rarely go in on the weekend. Okay, I'm here already, so I need to cut off the video here. See you later. Just keep left all the way, you reach the gantry for motorcycle. Okay, I'm back and now I'm heading to the Malaysia custom. And if you're going on this bridge, don't go too fast, because the wind here is very strong most of the time, but it's not that strong now. There was this one that was going quite fast, then the wind was so strong, you know, it's like suddenly it just hit you. So that time it hit me from the right side and I nearly hit the railing on the left side. So just go slowly. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention the toll fee amount. When you're at the Singapore custom, going in it's $1 SGD, when you're going out it's $1 SGD also, and for Malaysia when you're going in it's also $1 but ringgit, coming out also 1 ringgit. Some people actually don't pay the one at Singapore, because once you scan your thumbprint, the barricade basically just open that you can go through without paying. But I advise you not to do that because I have friends who got caught before. After you clear the Malaysia checkpoint, make sure you always check your passport. Make sure they chopped it already. Because what happened recently, when I say recent, I mean like just few weeks ago, my best friend and his girlfriend went to JB through here as well, just to have massage, you know, and eat supper and all to enjoy themselves. So when they go in, right, his girlfriend actually forgot to check her passport for the chop, any stamp or what. And there wasn't any. So when she came out, she had problem at the Malaysia custom. She didn't have stamp lah. They put her in a lockout for 7 days. And now she's banned from Malaysia for life. This is not a joke, it's fucking like a real thing that happened, and I was shocked when I heard it as well. It's also partially her fault lah, because she didn't check. And I know a lot of us don't check as well, so make sure you check next time lah. Okay, I've cleared the Malaysian custom. Now I'm going to the toll gate. So after you exit, just go straight all the way. Keep left lah. For bikes, no matter what gantry, checkpoint or whatever, just keep left lah. So if you want to buy touch and go, you go to the one that's the furthest. If it's not open like now, you can walk over to the first one for the car over there lah. Then you can just ask the person to for the card. Okay, so now I'm clear from all the custom and the toll. That's the petrol station we are going to. In order to get there, we need to make a very big and stupid U-turn. So the U-turn is pretty far away. If not, we can just get there easily. Okay, so the exit is after 312D. And it's this one. It has the Legoland sign. 312 to Iskandar Putri. I don't know how to pronounce, hope it's correct. Okay, after you turn out here, keep left again. And you can see on the left is another exit. So just take this exit. Basically, you can see Tuas. So we are just making a U-turn back to the same highway, so we can reach the petrol station later. The one that I showed you just now. So now we are going the direction back to Tuas. And you are going to look for the sign that's for R&R. Basically, you can see on the green signboard there will be petrol station icon, food icon and stuff. It's quite easy to recognize. Okay, so this is the sign I was talking about. And right about here, you can start to keep left. Then you exit from here. You can see Shell in front, Patrons in front, Patronas in front. So you can choose whichever you want. If you want to go back to Malaysia, it's basically the same thing. That's all. I'm going to have my supper now. Thanks for watching. Remember to subscribe if you haven't. If you have any question, please ask me in the comment. See you. Bye.